It's the 2K Sports pregame show.
Hello, everybody. Ernie Johnson here. Shaq's here. Kenny's here. Welcome to this edition of 2K Sports. And tonight our broadcast will be shifting to Atlanta, where we'll see the Hawks going up against the Chicago Bulls. For Chicago, things haven't exactly gone according to plan for them in the early going, as they've gone just 1-4 to start the season. They still haven't shaken off that rust from the offseason. And tonight, a chance to see the continued development of Lauri Markkanen, the 7-foot sharpshooter out of Finland. Kenny, your thoughts?
Not too many Finnish basketball players, but he's comes from a basketball family. Both his parents actually played pro hoops. Now, that's the first ever pick in the first round for Finland.
And he's able to finish around the rim.
He made history in Finland. Somewhat underrated as an athlete, he's another 7-footer out there shooting threes. I hate it, but you got to love it.
No question.
Why do we have to love it if you hate it?
Because I'm not a shooter.
I know.
PMFS, baby.
What is that?
Prolific, most frequently scorer.
Okay.
That does it for us. Thanks for tuning in. See you later.
That's what it means.
A view of the Atlanta skyline and all the action below it, as seen from the 17th Street Bridge. It's time for the NBA, live on 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan, joined by Greg Anthony, Steve Smith, and on the sideline, David Aldridge. Looking at Chicago, they want to turn it around after that loss to the Charlotte Hornets.
And, you know, this can happen on the road. You're out defending guys who have just gotten into a comfort zone playing at home.
Well, you have to have an aggressive mindset, and you have to try to disrupt their rhythm.
Tonight, Smitty, some teams that are really struggling. Two teams looking for answers to their troubles. They hope they find them.
Yeah, Kevin, you're totally right. These two teams, when you see, they make adjustments. But when the adjustments don't work, then you start to change the lineup and the rotations and the play call and who's the number one option, who's the number two option. And then when all that fails, then you start to hear the fan base. They start to come out with those boos. And as an organization, you don't need those.
All fueled up and ready to go. Brought to you by Gatorade. Let's check out who's on the floor. So the Bulls five right now. And down low, it's Markkanen and Carter. White is out there with Zach LaVine. And it's Porter at the small forward. One thing the Bulls did a great job of last year, Steve, moving the basketball.
They also had pace and space. They ran at every opportunity. The guys were very unselfish. Despite all the losses, the Bulls were a fun team to watch.
And he makes the first. Both free throws, good from Cramp.
Look at the Hawks and their history. For the most part, a very successful franchise. They've made the playoffs more often than not.
Young with the ball. A 24-point outing in their last game against Dallas.
You know what? I also like how he attacked the glass. Gave a terrific effort in that department.
Now here's Cramp. Six on the shot clock. Back to Collins. Uses the glass to finish the layup. And with the Hawks prior to last season, the franchise had been in the playoffs a remarkable 10 consecutive seasons.
Hawks still looking for their first title since moving to Atlanta. Typically, they've avoided long playoff droughts. Hopefully, this rebuild goes smoothly and they can get back in the hunt.
White. On the wing, Levine. He's guarded by Cram. Levine, good.
That's something Zach works on to round out his game. Consistency from the mid-range.
And on our sideline, our reporter, David Aldrich.
Well, I briefly spoke with Lloyd Pierce. He told me he's very pleased with how his team's play has progressed throughout the season. He said guys are finding their roles, and we're doing all the little things that tend to separate out the better teams. I just hope we can keep it going. Back to you, Kevin.
Thanks, David. Crab, no good. Here's White. 14 points from him the last game against Charlotte. Levine, good.
Such great balance and rhythm on this shot. Zach LaVine making it look easy.
Crab picks to Young. A floater. Carter with the block. Right side, LaVine. First quarter of basketball, just over 2.5 minutes played. Pass to Markkanen, outside White. He tries for three, and he's good on the three ball.
Lights out here, right out of the gate. Perfect 4-4 from the floor.
They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Too many empty possessions. Right now, they need a basket.
You know, he was looking for revenge, trying to match shots from distance.
LaVine wide open, and the Bulls tack on two more.
And what it looks like now, guys, their confidence is growing, and so is this lead.
But they can't just sit back and enjoy it. They need to keep up the momentum.
Chicago with the ball. They're rolling here with a 9-point run. And for Trae Young, it's a little unfair that he's already being compared to Steph Curry.
Scouts are always going to look for comparisons. And I'm not saying Young is Curry, but many of the strengths and weaknesses are similar. The size and athleticism, the insane range, and both have that it factor. Oh, perfect timing there to knock down the teardrop.
And White kicks to LaVine. And oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot two.
Zach LaVine, a high riser, the two-time dunk contest champ, making his return from that ACL surgery. He can be an explosive scorer.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And he makes the first. And from everything you hear, LaVine is a big-time gym rat, Greg.
Yeah, you know, I think he's very dedicated to reaching his full potential. And with his shooting and athleticism, I think he's a great fit in today's game in terms of offense.
And the Hawks with a completely new group on the floor. And so LaVine nails both of them.
I mean, thinking back to where LaVine was drafted, 13th overall, raised some eyebrows, but it was all about upside.
And now the first timeout called here for the Hawks. This is their first chance to take a look at the Bulls this season.
And going back to last season, they really struggled for wins. And even against a team like this with comparable talent, they didn't manage one win in the season series. chance to check out stats for Zach LaVine, how he performed last season. He put in about 16 points a game last year, 4 rebounds and 3 assists. And he's been putting up points with regularity. I mean, that's what they depend on, his killer instinct on offense.
Well, and we've seen defenses try to adjust, but he has the intelligence along with the talent, just finds new ways to beat them.
Now here's Parker. Carter with the block. 1:33 left in the first. Now LaVine. 20 points for him last game against the Hornets in Charlotte. And Jones sends it back. Herter, guarded by LaVine. Passes to Turner. Kicks to Parker. Nailed from three-point land.
And he likes to get in a rhythm early. Nice triple.
And so Sadoransky will bring it up for the Chicago Bulls. 4-point game. Jones against Carter. The pass to Valentine. Parker with the steal. Down low, Herter. Parker trying to free himself up. Banked in off the glass. 5 points in the game.
And a nice job here early of establishing an inside presence.
And he gets the bucket.
You get a chance to see the elite court vision there. Excellent pass.
Atlanta's gone 1-2 from long range in the first quarter. 3 seconds separate the shot clock and game clock. Ejected by Young, and he's able to get it back. And that one's good. Parker. 16 seconds left to play in the first quarter. Now here's LaVine. He's got 10. From outside the arc, and the last second attempt does not go in for him. We'll take a quick break and then back to the action here. Some good action already in this one, but a fairly even matchup after the first quarter of play. Looking at what we've seen from the Bulls, what do you guys think?
Through that first one, they've turned this thing into a track meet.
Fun to watch. They give you no time to set up on defense, and we see that reflected in the score.
Now we have a long season still ahead of us. Smitty, as a veteran, how much did you look to pace yourself as the season was going on, but in particular the early part of the season?
Great question, Kevin. I think you look at it as a veteran, you got to assess the situation. If you got to come out there and I guess push your pace as a veteran because you want a team to get off to a good start, hopefully the younger guys can continue that pace, or you have a team that is going well and they know you need them at the end. It's a tough call for some veterans, and that's why you see the veterans hanging around that can do both.
So for Chicago right now, we've got Sadoransky. Young is out there with Carter. Then it's Chris Dunn, and it's Valentine in at the three. The Bulls leading by 5. Dunn dishes to Carter. Pass to Sadoransky. Dunn outside. Just 5 on the clock. Makes it off the glass. Dunn's got the lead up to 7 now for Chicago.
I just love how Chris Dunn can change gears quick off the screen and then finishing the play.
Parker outside. And that'll be 2 free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul. And looking at Jabari Parker, 6'8", about 250 pounds. Greg, what's his best position?
you know, I think he has a small forward skill, but with the way the game is changing, you could see him play some power forward as well. And I think his best fit might just be at the four because of the mismatch he can create.
Free throw good by Parker. Young's checked in for Turner. And Chicago also making a switch. Markkanen's checked in. And Parker drops them both. Well, it feels quite a while ago that the Bulls put up 72 wins in a regular season.
Well, the Warriors beat that mark 2 decades later, and that was a few years ago. But give the Bulls credit. They've been trying to put together a contender. It's just kind of hard to find another Michael Jordan.
Now, here's Satoransky. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game. He kicks it to Valentine. Pass to Markkanen. There's the dish to Valentine. From deep. Atlanta with the rebound.
You don't want your best shooter heaving up that shot.
No, not at all. Coach is not going to like that one.
Pass to ABC. And here is Satoransky. The pass to Valentine. Back to Satoransky. Some nice ball movement by the Bulls. Markkanen against Jones. Markkanen kicks to Young. Here's Valentine. And again, no good by Chicago. The Hawks trail by 5. Here's ABC. And it falls over the rim and in. ABC's got his first 2 points.
Now that was pretty. A beautiful move to set up that jump shot.
Dunn against Young, down low, and Young with the basket on the assist from Dunn.
And good passing, setting up a lot of these buckets right now, Kevin. That's been the key.
To the middle, stolen by Satoransky. Young against Dunn. Pass to Satoransky. In the corner, Valentine with it. Shot clock at 6. The Bulls need to get a shot off here. Count it. And it's a 7-point Bulls lead.
Yeah, that's the third bucket in a row from the paint. This defense needs to clog those lanes in the middle.
Time call here. The Hawks decide to talk it over. And Smitty, you had perhaps some of your best seasons while a member of the Atlanta Hawks. What was it like being the face of this franchise during that time?
You know, I was proud to have led this team to so many playoff trips. It was fantastic being an Atlanta Hawk. It was also fun representing this team in the All-Star game. I played with some of the best in the business. Hall of Famer Dikembe Mutombo, All-Star Mookie Blaylock, and I played for a legendary Hall of Fame coach, Lenny Wilkins.
So for the Bulls, Otto Porter Jr., he's checked in for Valentine. Dean comes in for Satoransky, and it's wide in for Dunn. And so Young will bring it up for Atlanta. They trail by 7. Here's Hunter. He's guarded by Markkanen. Len against Porter. Len passes to Young.
I'll tell you, he just hasn't been able to get it done on the offensive end. It's kind of dragged down the team.
And White picks to Young. Back to White. Shoots it. Bulls with the first shot clock. Young's shot is off.
That's not the type of opportunity he fails to convert very often.
Young against White. And White with the block.
Marketing with the nice block shot. His size has been a factor in this game.
Levine feeling it out a bit. Kicks to White. Rejected by Len, but they recover it. The Hawks trail by 7. They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill.
Crab, good.
And really, it's been a major aspect of their offense in the early stages here. Their success working the ball inside and getting points from close range.
Now here's White. Outside, Porter. And Levine, here we go. Sinks that one from the post. Levine's got the lead back up to 7 now for Chicago.
The prototype of the new guard. Long, quick, highly skilled. Zach Levine has no trouble taking it inside.
Here's Collins. He had 16 points in the win against Dallas.
He owned the glass in that one, too. No one could put a body on him.
That's the kind of D that you're not going to find success with, guys. They've got to get a hand in the face.
And White kicks to Young. It's tipped, and the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Len.
And how about the reaction time on D there? Almost comes up with the pick.
You know, these are the little plays that can add up when you look over the course of a game.
Evan Turner, he's checked in for Young. And Chicago also making a switch. Carter, he's checked in for Young. 26 seconds left to play here in the half. White, good.
You can see there, the defender allows himself to get picked.
You know, it's all about effort. Sometimes you're going to get hit on hard screens. You just have to fight through them.
Now here's Cramp, guarded by Levine. Clock at 6. Pass to Turner. Over White. Count that one. The Bulls' lead has been cut down now to just 4 in the basket from Turner.
It's easy to tell that he is most comfortable pulling up from that area on the floor.
And some good action through the first 2 quarters as we reach halftime. Bulls out front, up by 4. 2K Sports back in a moment here in Atlanta.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Greetings, friends and neighbors. One half down, another half to go. Ernie Johnson, Shaquille O'Neal, Kenny the Jet Smith. It's the NBA on 2K Sports. Zach LaVine led the way in the first half. He had 12 points and 2 rebounds. And Kenny, what did you think about what you saw from Chicago?
Well, they showed a lot of discipline on offense, called some high percentage plays. Even when the defense devised different looks, they always seem to have the answer. That's good coaching.
And over to the big fella, your thoughts on the Hawks.
Well, I didn't even know who some of these guys were, but their bench came up with some big shots, gave the team a lift offensively. It's always possible those guys will see more minutes in the second half, but at the same time, if you're a starter, you're a starter for a reason. We shall see, Ernie.
And that'll about do it as we get ready for the second half. Let's take you down to Kevin Harlan.
Shout out to my man, Joel.
Joel, what up?
And we welcome you back with a look at such a terrific location here in the heart of downtown Atlanta. And as we get into this third quarter, as we've seen so far, neither team able to create much separation on the scoreboard yet. You look at Zach LaVine, he's really been playing well.
And let's see what the defense counters with to try and control him here in the second half.
Well, you like to run more doubles at him, but the risk there is opens up things for everybody else.
And we're halfway through this one. Plenty of basketball left in a game that's been fairly even so far. Chicago leading by 4. Steve, last season, even with Robin Lopez playing 64 games, the Bulls were dead last in block shots.
Yeah, Robin averaged less than one block a game for the first time in 6 years. What's really sad about that, he still led the team.
Alan Crabb out there with Young. And it's ABC. Then it's John Collins. And it's Len in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. That's the group starting the second half for Lloyd Pierce. The Bulls shooting their third and fourth free throw attempts of the game.
Two shots. Last on the first.
And that one falls for White. Smitty, walk us through what a typical NBA practice should look like and does look like.
Well, I think you come out, Kevin, first of all, they're spending a lot of times on making sure your body is ready to go into practice. And a lot of coaches love to start with offense first, and you can end with defense. And so that's where the intensity starts to pick up. And then last, you usually ends with some kind of shooting. So I think that obviously a lot of teams have different ways, but that's usually particular. You start with offense, you end with defense, and then you go into some individual work, and that's probably shooting.
Now here's Len, still looking for his first bucket in this one.
This is what the crowd comes to see. Young has that it factor.
Chicago leading. Payne passes to Markkanen. Carter outside. Over to the left wing. Young against White. Shot clock at 6. Porter kicks to Levine. It doesn't go for him. So Atlanta will take it the other way. To the inside. Len, that ties the game.
And the road back into this game wasn't a short one, but they've managed to make it all the way back and tie this thing up.
Now this team, they trust each other. Even down big, they have the ability to come back, and they have so far.
Here's White after the basket by Atlanta. Porter with it. The shot by Carter. Nobody around. And a miss there on the triple. Guys, we've seen some excellent offensive output.
Yeah, great momentum for them offensively.
They push it up, 4-on-3. Levine kicks to White. To the paint, here's Carter. A good finish at the rack off the slick feed. Carter's got 5 now.
That's the kind of aggressive and assertive play they need as we get closer and closer to crunch time.
Atlanta calls timeout.
Atlanta Hawks.
Cheers. So, Smitty, you played here in Atlanta for so many years. What are some of your favorite spots or things to do in Atlanta?
Well, I love to eat, and two of my favorite places are Busy Bee Cafe, just love that, and Umi. Then what I love to do is try to get a little exercise. I love to walk Chastain Park. The fans here, the city of Atlanta, I just love it so much. We've made it home.
Both teams will make substitutions.
One more time.
Now we'd like to take this moment to show you the teams that a year ago made a trademark of scoring points off turnovers. Number 5, the Hawks.
And this team, in terms of scoring off of turnovers, that became the identity. I mean, they really look to disrupt and cause problems defensively. And boy, do they take advantage on the other end.
Dishes to Young. Hands it from downtown.
Yeah, D with very little pressure on their perimeter shooters. 3 of the last 5 baskets they've allowed have been from beyond.
Now, here's Satoransky. Still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him. Down low. Here's Carter. And he overshot that one, missing.
Just 1 for 4 since the break. They are looking for better efficiency on the offensive end.
Herter, Young trying to break free, and the rebound paying off as they pick up 2 on the second chance bucket right there.
just crushing it here. 80% to start the half.
Now, here's Valentine, covered by Parker. Done against Young, shoots from 14. Nice spin off the left rim and in.
Hitting contested jumpers, it's a must to be a scorer in this league. Nice shot by Chris Dunn.
Young outside. Chalk up two there.
Well, you look at the coaching resume of Lloyd Pierce. Was an assistant for a lot of teams in his time. Stops at Memphis and Philadelphia most notably. Finally gets a chance to be the head coach here in Atlanta.
Here's Satoransky following the basket by Trae Young. Winners checked in for Atlanta. Young's checked in for the Bulls. Substitution on the court. A little under 2.5 minutes off the clock now here in the third. Now here's Valentine. He's guarded closely. Just 5 on the clock. From deep. Rebounded by the Hawks. And with Coach Pierce, the most recent stop was in Philadelphia.
Pierce was a big part of the Sixers' turnaround, was tasked with the defensive duties, and had a very successful track record with that. Was empowered by Brett Brown to design the defense, and that has become his calling card as a coach.
Oh, perfect timing there to knock down the teardrop.
Atlanta's gone 4 of 8 tonight from three-point land, shooting 50% on the three ball here. Herter, Satoransky covering. To the inside, stolen by Satoransky. Yep, that one goes. Jones has got the lead up to 3 now for Atlanta.
Hard to imagine them losing this game if they can keep shooting like that.
And there's the foul. It goes on Evan Turner. That is his first foul of the game. And the Hawks making a change here. Hunter's checked in. And a change for the Bulls. Markkanen, he's checked in for Valentine. 1:32 left to play in the third. Young outside. And Satoransky kicks to Porter. 5 to shoot. That one good for 2.
Whether it's scoring, passing, or just acting as a decoy, his value to this team cannot be understated.
Over to the left wing. Nobody near Parker. That ball. Nice speed that time from Turner. That's 7 points for Parker.
And since halftime, they have been locked and loaded from beyond.
Yeah, forcing defenders to come out and guard them, which could open up driving lanes if they want to take advantage of that.
Now, here's Porter. Dunn, right side. Here's Satoransky, and the layup's good off the glass. Satoransky's got his first 2 points of the night.
What I like is when Chris Dunn keeps his poise, keeps his eyes up, good things happen.
ABC passes to Jones. Here's ABC. Jones looking for an opening. And 2 free throws coming up, unable to get that one to go with all the contact. It's on Thaddeus Young.
And really the defense fouling there to prevent the layup, but that's exactly what you need to do.
For Atlanta, they have been solid at the line so far. 4 for 4.
2 shots. And just to mention, a season ago, they were very comfortable at the line, hitting about 78% of their free throws. 2 shots.
The free throw drops for Hunter. So both teams making some changes here. He's perfect from the line this time. 19 seconds left in the third quarter. Here's White. 6 points for him. There's the three. And that one released in time, but no good. And don't go away. We'll be right back. And let's go back to a terrific pass that we're calling tonight our State Farm assist of the game.
Just true artistry right there. I mean, great decision on where to go with the ball, and how about the perfect delivery?
Execution. This is what you practice every day. These guys are professionals. Beautiful play.
And it's been a very competitive game so far as we get rolling here in quarter number four. Atlanta leading by four on the court for the Bulls, getting this fourth quarter started. Otto Porter Jr. out there with Young. Then it's Zach LaVine. Then it's Lauri Markkanen. And it's White in at the point. Collins kicks to Hunter. Shakes off the strong D and gets the bucket for two.
Hunter's
got the first field goal of the fourth quarter here for the Hawks. White the pass to Markkanen. Young inside. He's guarded by Collins. LaVine can't hit.
A good board there, Kevin, but overall they're getting slightly out-rebounded.
Now here's Cram, guarded by LaVine, stolen by Markkanen. White the pass to LaVine.
Whoa!
Good.
Beautiful.
Beautiful. The creativity, extreme athleticism. You see why Zach's won the dunk contest multiple times.
And that last replay, courtesy of the Under Armour Hover Havoc, unleashing a little bit of chaos. Now here is Young. Down goes basket number six for him this game. He's taken 12 shots and made half of them.
See, in this half, I feel like he's a much different shooter. Calm, focused, and letting things come to him.
Time called here. The Bulls decide to talk it over. Without question, Trae Young displaying his skills today.
You know, this is the right move. Maybe a break in the action will cool him down.
Bulls making a switch here. Carter's checked in. And on our sideline, our reporter, David Aldridge.
Well, I was able to listen in on what Jim Boylan was going over with his team. He was not happy with their defensive performance. He said they're getting everything they want. We've got to show them we can't let that happen. You have to make a stand. You have to get some stops. And that'll get us going on a run. Guys.
Thank you, David. First minute and a half of basketball played here in the fourth quarter. And Young kicks to Hunter. Passes it to Collins. Six on the shot clock. Bulls trail by six. And the pass to White. Trying his luck deep. Sinks the triple.
And defensively, neither side able to get many stops.
Well, this is when you need them, late in the game. It's not all about scoring.
Now, here's Collins. Glenn finds Young, and denied. He sends it right off the glass. Outside, White. Knocked loose, stolen by Collins. The kick out to Young. Porter with the steal. Fast break, here comes Chicago to tie it up. The rebound by Young.
You know, and after fighting to get back into it, that was the chance there to tie it up.
Ever so close. Needed that one to go down.
They are just killing them on the interior.
And over 2.5 minutes in the books here in the fourth. And Levine, here we go. Doesn't go for him.
I mean, he's struggling, hitting a low percentage of his shots this quarter.
Crab, and it's good off the back of the rim and in. And the Hawks lead by 7. The Bulls have gone just 33% from the field in the fourth quarter so far. They are 2 of 6. Bean passes to Carter. Len grabs the board. Len's got his 4th rebound in this one. Pass to Hunter. And he drops it in from the low post. And now it's a 9-point Atlanta lead.
Really, really good possession there. They've never lost their focus, even as the game's gotten tight.
With their lead starting to stretch out just a little bit here late, they're in a prime position now to wrap this one up.
Now here's Levine. And the foul called on ABC. That is his first foul of the game. Parker's checked in for John Collins. Chicago calls timeout. And during this timeout, I'm sure they'll be hydrating themselves with Gatorade. All the effort out there on the floor. And these timeouts can be such a huge factor in getting a short rest and recharging the battery. Now to recognize our Jordan player of the game, Trae Young.
And he's played this entire game on his front foot, Kevin. I mean, driving the lane, going to the rim with purpose, and getting those points the hard way.
A really solid performance here in front of the home crowd. He may not be the star of this team, but nights like this are what make him a fan favorite. Now here's White. And a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot 2 here. It's going to be on Trae Young. Player podcast, something we're hearing more of, and it's a growing trend. Good idea, or do you think it could get some guys in trouble?
Kevin, well, some guys, it does a good job of helping their brand, and we love to see guys getting a chance to do other things off the court. And then there are some guys who get a little loose, and they reveal some secrets or they say some things they wish they could take back. So I think it all comes out to the individual. You got to understand media before you try to jump out and start doing these podcasts.
Well said. And both free throws good for White. And so Young will bring it up for the Hawks. Bulls trail by 7. Here's White. And oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot 2.
At the line for the Bulls, White. taking two shots. Under sticks.
He drops the first one, and that trims the lead to six. And he makes both free throws.
And good aggressive basketball on that trip, drawing the foul, converting the free throws, and then also narrowing the gap.
White against Young. Feeds it to Land. And the dunk by Land.
You just can't leave anyone open around Young. He's very capable of spotting his uncovered teammates.
Bulls trail by seven. Now White. He kicks to Levine. 1:32 left in the fourth quarter. Fades, and he banks that one home. And that's now 7 points for Wendell Carter.
Man, did they need those points, and I bet he's the guy that continues to go for it.
He will use his size, his skills, and his shooting ability to go get this win.
Here's Hunter. Parker outside. Here's the floater, and it's good on the way in. And the Hawks lead by seven.
The beauty of the teardrop, very difficult to really contest.
White against Young, pass to Porter. Count it!
And it was the screen there, guys, that freed him up as he ran his man into it.
And then it was all acceleration, GA, to the bucket right after that.
That was just a textbook pick that allowed him room, and he took advantage of it.
And the Hawks with possession here after Chicago picking up a basket just moments ago. Down to five on the shot clock. Stolen by Levine.
And this is not a time to be patient with the basketball.
Yeah, for sure. They need a quick score and a foul just to have a chance.
Oh, man, what a turnaround. Sensational play on D and then the rapid-fire run to the basket.
Craig, they didn't wait around, did they? They went right for the throat.
They want to get out and run any chance they get. Superb D that generated into easy offense for them.
And they commit an intentional foul. We'll see another one of those so they can get into the penalty.
Had to foul, and on that occasion, to stop the clock. That's the enemy in this situation.
Here's Cram, and they go to the intentional foul.
Two shots. Gentlemen, two shots. Loose shots.
He doesn't hit the first, and that was the one they really wanted. He's got one more, though.
And the comparisons to Steph Curry, it's understandable. Young's shooting ability is off the charts.
And he does get the second one, and that will put them up by two. Chicago calls timeout. They're behind by two. There's 14 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. What's your take, guys?
And it all comes down to this. Still enough time on the clock that they should be able to get a real good look.
A lot of time left, which should allow for a really good shot if they run the right play.
We'll be right back. Levine kicks to White. Got it up in time. Oh, that shot had a chance, but no good. And so the big win by Atlanta in a tight game. What a show they put on here at home tonight.
I mean, these are those games that feel so great to win, and really, it's like a knife in the gut to lose. You got to love being on edge of your seat and just wondering what's going to happen. How is this thing going to play out?
And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thank you, Kevin. Jabari, you guys really got after it tonight. Is this the kind of mentality you want to impose on the other team?
Just as long as I stay aggressive. You know, don't rush the game. Don't get outside of my game. But continue to play hard.
Well, you got your teammates looking for you tonight, Jabari. Thanks. Back to you, Kevin.
David, thank you as always. And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. For Steve Smith, Craig Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan thanking you for tuning in. So long, everyone.